Welcome to all of you. Myself, Niranjan Jena, faculty member of Department of Civil Engineering, Jharsuguda Engineering School, Jharsuguda. So today we discuss a new topic. As per the SETBT syllabus, so there is a chapter compass traversing. So today we discuss why we will go for the compass traversing. So first, in initial first two chapter you studied, there is a measurement of line measurement by using the chain, tape, direct ranging, indirect ranging by using the ranging rods. Then why will you go for this compass traversing? In the chain surveying, suppose it's a whole area. Suppose this is an area. This area is divided into small, small triangles. Based upon the principle whole to part. We are working on whole to part. That's the first principle. That means we divide the area into small, small. We divide the area into small, small triangles. When the ground is a fairly level ground and the area is very small, on that case you can use your compass traversing. But when the ground is very large and that is a undulated ground, undulating and large. When the ground is a undulated and large ground, on that condition you will go for the compass traversing. By using the compass, you can measure two parameters. First one is angle, second is the direction. That means you can measure the north south direction and the angles. In surveying, that angle is noted as bearing. In surveying, the angle is written as bearing. That means you can measure the angles, you can measure the direction. For measurement of or finding the north and south direction, we are using magnetic compass. The magnetic compass will show you direction. For finding the bearings, we will use the surveyor compass or prismatic compass. The angle is designated on the compass as a circle, so you can measure the angles. Then, what is the meaning of traversing? So, first we will discuss. Compass means it's an instrument which is used for the measurement of angle. Then what is the meaning of traversing? Traversing means it's the interconnected lines. Suppose A point, B point, C point, D point, E point, and again A point. In there is five stations, A, B, C, D, E. That is the main stations. If you traverse, go through the station A to station B, station B to station C, C to D, D to E, A, that is means interconnected lines. So traversing is means interconnected lines. So this is the introduction. I will go for the compass traversing. When the ground is very undulated and large, you can use the compass to measure the direction and bearings. So next we discuss some definitions. There is true bearing, magnetic bearing, declination, and I will explain each term. Then first point, true bearing. First I will discuss true bearing. Second, magnetic bearing. And third, declination. True bearing, magnetic bearing, declination and azimuth. So these four terms, you should first familiar with these four terms. First one, true bearing. When you join the geographical south and geographical north point in your globe, if you join the north pole and south pole. When you join the geometrical north and geometrical south, this is known as your true bearing, actual north and actual south. So it is got from TB. Then what is the meaning of magnetic bearing? When you freely suspended the magnetic compass
Just place your magnetic compass and it will be freely suspended without local attraction. Freely suspended, it will show a direction of north and south. That is north as per the actual geography. It may be in the east direction, like this, or it may be like this. North south or north south. The line which is represented in white color, that is the magnetic bearing. Why? Because the compass is not only shown to two variables. When you freely suspend it, it will show some direction. Maybe east side or west side. So this is the magnetic bearing due to the magnetic compass. Then what do you mean by declination? Declination means it's the angle between the true north and magnetic bearing. So declination you can follow between the true bearing and magnetic bearing. The declination will you can found the true bearing and magnetic bearing. In this picture you can see this color is my true bearing and this is magnetic bearing. So this angle is known as declination towards west. My needle should be actually in this position, but it is inclined to the west. It is known as west declination. If your magnetic needle is inclined to the east, it is known as east declination. This is the angle. East declination. It may be east side, it may be west side. Then which side you will take positive and which side you will take negative? For the east, you always, there is a formula, we will explain here. True bearing is equal to magnetic bearing plus or minus declination. True bearing means actual reading is magnetic bearing plus or minus declination. Bearing means angle. So in case of east, suppose this is the north, south. But here, this is the magnetic bearing and this is true bearing. Suppose there is a line AB in this direction. A, B. True bearing is always measured from the true north. True bearing is always measured from the true north. Then magnetic bearing is measured from the magnetic line. The magnetic bearing will be measured from this magnetic line. Then you can check the formula. True bearing, the total angle will be magnetic bearing plus declination. If you add the two angles, angle 1 and angle 2, then you can get the angle 3. So true bearing is the total angle is magnetic bearing plus declination. In the case of east, it is plus. And same principle in west, it will be minus. Next move to azimuth. Azimuth means it's an angle which is always measured from the north. Suppose north, south, east and west. Suppose here is angle. Your azimuth is always clockwise. You don't think the angle will be this angle. No. This is not azimuth. Your azimuth is always measured from the north and it will be clockwise direction. In your semester exam, definitely you will get 2-mark question from this azimuth. Azimuth means it's the bearing of line which is always measured from the north and that direction should be clockwise. I think this 4 term is clear to all of you. First, true bearing, true north, magnetic bearing, the magnetic north, declination and azimuth. Next, we discuss how to convert the whole circle bearing to quadrant bearing. In the bearing there is two system. In surveying, in the bearing we represent two system. So first system is whole circle bearing and second system is quadrantal bearing. From this quadrantal rod, if your quadrant means there is four quadrant. Then I will explain here with the figure. north, south, east, and west. There is four quadrant. First, second, third, fourth.
So now we can check.
Whole circle bearing means the angle which is in between 0 to 3, 60 degree. Because this angle is always measured from the north. But quadrantal bearing, this angle is measured from north pole or south pole. First listen the difference. In whole circle bearing, it is always measured from the north. And the quadrantal bearing is measured from north or south, whichever is nearer. So I will explain the four terms. Suppose this is light AB, AC, AD, A. Suppose this is the line AB, AC, AD, A. Then what will be the whole circle bearing for line AB? Because whole circle bearing is measured from the north pole. So it is clear? Here. Whole circle bearing. Then what is the quadrantal bearing? Quadrantal bearing is measured from the north and south. Whichever is nearer. Whichever is nearer. So in the first quadrant, if you measure the angle from south, definitely it will be a large angle. So whole in the angle 0 to 90 degree, the whole circle bearing and quadrantal bearing both are same. So you can break down the table for much. For your easy understand, you can prepare a tabular form. Whole circle bearing, quadrantal bearing, and quadrantal. So first, whole circle bearing, 0 to 90 degree. When the whole circle bearing is 0 to 90 degree, then the quadrantal bearing is same, 0 to 90. So it is in between 0 to 90, it will be same in the first quadrant. What is the direction of quadrant? Northeast. The angle is always measured from the north angle. So here the quadrant is northeast. In the second four line, AC. You can measure the angle from north pole or south pole. But for the whole circle bearing, the angle is always measured from the north pole. So you can measure this angle. This angle is your whole circle bearing. For the angle, you can check 90 to 180. It is in between 90 to 180. For 90 to 180, whichever is nearer, this is the large angle, this is whole circle bearing. You should convert to quadrantal bearing. So this is the near angle. How can I calculate this angle? Total 180 minus this. So the formula for quadrantal bearing, 180 minus angle. 180 minus whole circle bearing. Whole circle bearing.
Then what is the direction?
You check the direction south-west. Because your arrow is in the direction from south towards east. Your direction will be southeast. Then for the line AD, azimuth is always measured from the north. This is the azimuth. So right here, 180 to 270 degree. Your azimuth is from the north, always. But the quadrantal bearing, it will measure the angle whichever is near. You can measure from the north, you can measure from the south. Which angle is nearer? This is a small angle from the south. So your quadrantal bearing will be the whole circle bearing minus 180. To minus this angle, and easily you can get this quadrantal bearing. So it will be whole circle bearing minus 180 degree. If you minus up to this angle, then you can find the small angle. Minus 1.
Then what is the direction?
Direction? Your arrow direction. Your arrow starts from south towards west. So here your direction will be south west.
Next move to the last part.
The angle A to P. So the whole circle bearing is measured from the north. So you can write here 270 to 360. Then what is the quadrantal bearing? You can measure from the north or you can measure from the south. Whichever is lesser. So you can check in this figure. This is the small angle. This is the less angle. So how can you calculate this angle? Total 360 minus 1 cm. Total angle is 360 up to this north. You can deduct this whole circle bearing, then you can get quadrangle bearing. So here formula 360 minus whole circle bearing. Now we can check the direction. In which direction? Your arrow is starting from the north pole towards the west. So here the direction is northwest. So this is the conversion of your bearing. Easily you can remember by a small figure, by a small picture. North, south, east, west. You just remember a trick. How can you find the angle? Then to chapter 1. You can measure the angle from northwest, northeast, southeast, southwest. This is the easy concept. You just remember this figure. With the formula also we can calculate. The angle will be northeast direction, northwest, southeast, southwest. So in your full chapter, when you are using the bearing, bearing means angle. So this is the total tabular format. How can you convert from whole circle bearing to quadrangle bearing? Next, I will just discuss your two important terms. That is core bearing and bed bearing. If you want to take the screenshot, you can take the screenshot of conversion. Next, core bearing and bed bearing. The core bearing is represented as AB, core bearing, and bed bearing BB. Core back. Core means forward in the direction of your survey. Back means backward direction of your survey. The angle is always measured from the north. Because geographical north and south pole is our reference line. So how can I measure the angle? Suppose this is the line. Then you can check in this figure which angle is the core bearing. Suppose this is A, B. That means I am moving from A to B, not B to A. Forward direction. A to B. I am traveling or conducting the survey from A to B. So now you can check. The angle of line, the bearing of line is always measured from the north. So this angle is the core bearing. Then where is the back bearing? If you measure the angle from the north pole in backward direction, your forward direction is A to B. That's the core bearing. Your backward direction is B to A. In the backward direction of survey, you can measure the back bearing. Always the angle is measured from the north. So this angle is your back bearing. And there is an important check. Fore bearing and back bearing, the difference will be 180 degree. The difference will be always 180 degree. On the coming video, I will discuss. If angle is not 180 degree, then what are the errors in surveying? Maybe the local attraction, maybe the personal errors, instrumental errors, there are different type of errors. But this term is important for your exam point of view. You will get a 1-5 mark question of conversion of this angle. Or you can give a question to conversion of fore bearing and back bearing on included angle. On the coming classes, I will discuss how can you calculate the included angles, then the numerical based upon this concept. So if you have any doubt in the today's lecture, you can just comment on the comment section. Otherwise, ask your doubt through my mail ID. Then on the coming video, I will discuss the next part of this compass. Thank you to all of you.